Are you looking for something fun to do with your online team or group? This video shows you 5 free and easy online activities. All that is required is a voice call with the ability to screen share. The activities mixes games with conversation and are a great alternative to a regular group chat. Let's get started. The first activity requires little introduction.
This is Jeopardy!
This game show has been around since 1964 and is still going strong. But a lot has happened since 1964, including that you can now play yourself online. You can do that on a site called Jeopardy Labs. Here you can find Jeopardy games with all kinds of topics, or you can create your own. To play, simply find a quiz topic you like, pick the number of teams and the quizmaster, and then you're ready to play. The online game has two main differences from the TV version. There is no fancy buzzer system, and you will most likely play in teams. To buzz in for a question, each team must agree on the buzzer sound. I can recommend animal sounds, but that is up to the teams to decide. When a question is selected and read aloud by the quizmaster, the first team to buzz in get to answer first. The quizmaster is the final judge of who buzzed in first. If the team gets the correct answer, they are awarded with points. Otherwise, they lose points and the other team gets a chance to buzz in and answer. It's often more fun to create your own quiz, though it takes some time to prepare. To create a game, simply click the button, choose a password so you can access it later, and start building. You can also add pictures or sounds to your questions, but some features require a small payment. It is not really needed though, but it's an option. The next activity is called Secret Character. It's a game I played a lot over the years and it works really well online. To get started, make a list of all participants and share it with the group. Pick a player on the list at random. That player now has to think of a famous person or character and keep the choice hidden from the other players. The only criteria for the pick is that it should be someone who is commonly known, like Donald Duck, Donald Trump, or Napoleon. When the game starts, the next person on the pre-made list gets to ask a question which will help identify the secret character. As an example, let's say the picker has picked Harry Potter. The first player asks, is the secret character a woman? And the picker answers no. Then the next player asks a question, and so on. Instead of asking a question, the player may guess who they think the secret character is, based on the previous answers. If a player decides to guess, the guess must be revealed to the rest of the group. If the guess is correct, the player gets a point, otherwise the player is out of the round and cannot ask any more questions or guess again. The round continues until the secret character has been guessed or until everyone has guessed wrong. In the next round, pick the next player on the list and play until someone reaches whatever point goal you agree on. Do you like drawing? Do you like guessing? Then this activity is for you, because the goal is to do exactly that, drawing and guessing. The easiest way to play is to use a site called Scribble. Just choose a name, choose your language, pick an appearance, and press play. Inside the game, players take turns to draw and guess. So right now another player is drawing, and I have to guess. The drawing looks like peas to me, so I'll type peas in the chat. That was correct, so I'm awarded points at the end of the round. My turn to draw, so I gotta pick a word. I don't know, let's go with sunglasses. Face. Eyes, alright. And the glasses. And I probably gotta add, like, yeah, a sun or something. Let's try that. As you can see, I'm not very good at drawing, but to be honest, it doesn't really matter and it makes the game more fun. And hey, it looks like someone did guess my sunglasses, so yeah, it's possible even though you're not good at drawing. If you want to play with your team or group, simply click the Create Private Room button. Select the number of rounds, the draw time, the language, and invite people to play by using the link in the bottom. If you are not able to use Scribble or just want to play in teams instead of a free-for-all, you can take turns to screen share any painting program. The game plays out in the exact same way, except for the team part. You can use a random word generator to generate a list of items to draw. It can also be a good idea to have a quiz master, or drawing master if you will, to keep track of points and distribute drawing subjects to the teams. I added a few extra instructions to play the game this way, but now I think it's time to move away from my very questionable drawings. The next activity is less about talking and more about watching. It's called Watch Together, and it gives your group the opportunity to synchronize YouTube videos so you can watch them together. In preparation for this activity, all participants should find a video they would like to share with the group. The video can be funny, informative, or crazy. That is up to you. Only requirement is that the video is rather short or that you only show a small part of it. I recommend a couple of minutes max, but it also depends on the number of participants. When everyone is ready with their video picks, launch the site Watch Together. Here you are, of course, greeted with a cat video. What else? But when you're done watching the poor cats behind the invisible wall, invite the group by sending them the link in your group chat. When everyone is ready, simply paste the first video link into the link grabber. The video will then start to play for everyone in your group at the same time. Groundbreaking technology compared to count from three and press play at the same time.
Hello and welcome to an introduction.
If the watching part gets too silent for you, have all participants explain why they picked the video they did. That usually results in some interesting conversation. On a side note, you can find similar sites that allow you to watch streaming services like Netflix together even though you are apart. Sometimes simple is good, and a regular quiz is a great example of that. Divide the group into teams of maximum 4 people and pick a quiz master. There are many options for questions, for instance the site called Quiz Questions. It doesn't win any design prizes, but it has a lot of random questions and even a dinosaur category. Not bad. You can also use the questions from a quiz board game. Pick a number of categories and create a spinning wheel with them. The wheel decides the category for the team. Add a few jokers, which allow the team to pick the question category. Share the screen of the quizmaster and spin the wheel to select a category. Read a question from the category and give the team 1 minute to discuss the answer. If they get it right, they get 1 point, 0 otherwise. If they fail to answer correctly, give the opposing team the chance to guess for 1 point. The second team must answer quickly though, otherwise the game will drag out. So yes, the quiz is a bit simple, but in my experience it works really well. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching and good luck with your online team activities.